In the last video, we factored this polynomial in order to find the real roots. We factored it by grouping, which is essentially doing the distributive property in reverse twice. And I mentioned that there's two ways you could do it. You could actually, from the get-go, add these two middle degree terms and then think about it from there. And so what I thought I would do is just a quick video on that alternative. So if we add, instead of grouping, if we add these middle two terms, actually I'll just focus on the fourth degree polynomial here. We know that we have an x out front. This fourth degree polynomial is going to simplify to x to the fourth plus 7x squared plus 7x squared minus 18. And now if we want to factor this, we could recognize a pattern here. So you probably remember, or hopefully remember. If you don't, then you might want to review your factoring polynomials. But if you have x plus a times x plus b, that's going to be equal to x. It's going to be equal to x squared plus the sum of those two numbers, a and b, as being the coefficient on the x term, plus the product of those two numbers. And if you just multiply this out, this is what you would get. But if this was x squared plus a times x squared plus b, then instead of this being x squared, this would be x to the fourth. And instead of this being x, this would be x squared, which is exactly the pattern we have here. So what two a's and b's that if I add them up, I would get 7. And if I were to take their product, I get negative 18. Well, since their product is negative, we know that they are of different signs. One will be positive, one will be negative. And since their sum is positive, we know that the larger of the two numbers is going to be positive. And so what jumps out at me is 9 times negative 2. You multiply those, you get negative 18. You take their sum, you get 7. And so we can rewrite this, just looking at this pattern here, as x squared plus 9 times x squared minus 2. I could say plus negative 2, the same thing as x squared minus 2. And then that's exactly what we got right over here. And of course, you have this x out front that I didn't consider right over here. And then this, as we did in the previous video, you can recognize as a difference of squares, and then factor it further to actually find the roots. But I just wanted to show you that you could solve this by regrouping, or you can solve this by just, I guess you could say, more traditional factoring means. And notice, this 9 and negative 2, this is what was already broken up for us so that we could factor by regrouping.